solution to this example. So what we're going to do is we're going to create a chart per division. So let's just set up the first one, and I'm going to say we're going to do a nice column chart, and you'll see that's there. Now, just a trick in order to create the same chart again and again, instead of resetting it up, I'm just going to click on this one, copy it, click here, paste it. And when you clicked on it, you'll see it's got the boxes highlighted. All I'm going to do is just drag down where it looks. So same thing, copy and paste, and let's do that one as well, paste it, and tell it this one actually should be division 3, and that's division 4. So that looks okay, but notice that they all look very similar, even though the scales show that they're vastly different relative sizes. In order to make them all work to the same scale, what we've done is we've created an item here, and we've actually created a max. So what we've said is please find the biggest number you can find in all of these. And now what we're going to do is link this series into all of these, so they all have a common series. So let's go like this, I'm going to copy it, and I can now go into each one and paste it, paste it, paste it, paste it. So notice now that all of them have a scale of 1,000, but obviously we've got this orange line, which is a bit annoying. It's not exactly what we want. So the way to get rid of it is we're going to hide it. So we're going to go and say format data series. First thing we're going to do is we're going to overlap them so we don't notice it. Secondly, we're going to fill it and say no, we don't want any fill here. So if you look there, you'll see it's now showing that, which is exactly what we want. We could repeat this process, but remember another way is we can use a format painter of sorts. So I'm going to click on that, copy it, go here, say paste special format, and you'll see it does exactly that. Paste special format, paste special format. And now we have a situation where all these items are linked using a common scale. If the numbers change, the scale will always be the same on all of them, and we'll be able to easily see which one is the biggest, which one is the smallest, and then look at the trend.